Hello, and in this video, we are going to learn how to turn 1 into 001 in Excel. All the proper term for it is how to add leading zero. And then later on, we are also going to learn how to add both text and leading zero before a number and still have Excel treated as a number, such as EN001. Okay, so let's get to it. In many instances, we would have to work with ID numbers that by nature need to have a few zeros before the actual number. In this video, we are using student name and student ID as an example, but in reality, it could be anything from product numbers, parts numbers, customer ID, or membership ID. So our problem is, we want to input these ID numbers as a 3-digit number, such as 001, but whenever we press enter, Excel will automatically remove the two zeros before the number 1, which is not what we want. Of course, there are many workaround solutions. First, we can put a single quote before entering the number, and this will force Excel to treat the number as text, or we can format the column as text, and basically anything that is typed there will appear exactly as it is entered. But both these methods have problems. Now that these ID numbers are stored as text, it will be impossible to sort them by numbers or to do a filter from largest to smallest or to perform any basic calculation. If I want to put every 20 students into a separate group and assign a supervisor to them, I cannot do that. In reality, it will be really, really messy if you have large data of, let's say, 1,000 customers and you want to select only the first 50 customers for a special promotion. So what can we do? Let's first select the whole column and then open the numbers dialog. Some of you might already have gone there and concluded that there's nothing suitable, but really just keep on looking a little bit harder until you go to the last category, which is custom. And in the type dialog, it might look a bit confusing, but don't worry, just press 000 there, and basically what this will do is that it will tell Excel that we want a 3-digit number, that we want to keep the leading zeros whenever possible. So let's press OK and see what will happen. And you can see that all our cells now have leading zeros, and we're just going to test if it works by pressing 007. Yes. Actually, we can also just enter 9 and it will be automatically converted into 009. So let's try with 21. And 1, 2, 3. So now we can conclude that it will work. But actually, if you look closer, the second and the third cell, the format is a little bit funny. And if you will look closer, you will see the warning arrow here. And this is because these numbers are being stored as text. So now we will need to convert them into numbers first, and then apply format painters. And now all our cells will have leading zeros exactly the way we want it to be. If your ID number consists of both text and leading zero, for example, these students are engineering students and we want the ID numbers to be EN001, you might think we will need to use a special Excel function such as concatenate or join strings. But it will be quite messy because this function only works with text and not text and number. A simple solution is to go back to format number, go to custom, and in the type dialog, we just press whatever text we want to enter, which is, in our case, is EN. Now, you remember that if we enter text, we will need to put them inside two double quotes. And just press OK. And yes, now we are done. Better still, this is being treated as numbers, and we can sort and filter any way we like. So I'm just going to sort them largest to smallest. And that's it. We have the best of both worlds without any messy formula.